This is the 14-inch Samsung Galaxy Book 4 Edge, and it's Samsung's very first Copilot Plus PC with Qualcomm's ARM-based Snapdragon X Elite chipset. I've already covered this laptop from a lot of different angles on this channel, but it's now the time to finally put it all together for a full review. After using it for a little more than a month, I have a lot of positive and negative thoughts about this laptop, Windows on ARM, and where this is all hopefully heading. And I can safely say that Windows on ARM is finally good now. But there are a ton of caveats in these early stages that doesn't make it great, not yet at least. So if you're thinking about buying the Galaxy Book 4 Edge or any ARM laptop with a Snapdragon X Elite chip, definitely watch till the end so you can see if this is actually the right laptop for you. Let's start with how nice this laptop looks. It only comes in this sapphire blue color. It looks more like silver in a lot of lighting conditions, but it's beautiful. It passes the one hand open test. I love the brushed aluminum look. The slim bezels weighs only 1 kilogram, and the wedge design underneath makes this laptop even slimmer than it already is at only 10 millimeters. It doesn't even skimp out on the ports either. Two USB 4.0 Type-C ports, one HDMI 2.1 supporting up to 4K 60Hz, and an audio jack. There is no Windows Hello support, but the fingerprint reader is really fast and accurate, so this laptop really has everything you need. But the one caveat I'll mention is the build quality and the actual feel. The Galaxy Book 4 Edge is built with a mix of aluminum, glass, and recycled plastic, and it's obvious where it is made of plastic materials. It might not look like it, but there actually is a lot of creaking even when you're just holding the laptop or adjusting the display angle. And to achieve this lightweight and thinness, the top lid is really, really thin. So without much weight and density on this lid, closing the laptop doesn't have a nice or satisfying sound. These trade-offs are for thinness and portability, which are important, but honestly, the build quality just doesn't feel as well built as some of the other top productivity laptops, especially at this price range. Personally, I would have preferred them making this a little thicker and denser to give more of a premium feel. That sadly also applies to the trackpad. The nice part about it is that it's really smooth and spacious. I thought the response and sensitivity are really great, gestures also work super well, but it being a traditional non-haptic trackpad, you can't click above the middle point. If it was just 2 years ago, this would have been one of the best trackpads on a Windows laptop, but with a lot of other Windows laptops at this price transitioning to high quality haptic trackpads, this one feels a bit out of place and doesn't give off that high end premium feel when clicking on it. On the bright side though, I love this keyboard. The spacing is perfect, travel is just enough to feel tactile and not too shallow. I love that it's perfectly centered without really placed keys on the sides or corner. I definitely prefer this keyboard over the MacBooks, and it feels just as comfortable and fast to type on as on a Microsoft Surface laptop keyboard. And here's how it actually sounds. And probably the true highlight for the hardware here is the 14-inch 3K AMOLED display. It's got a touchscreen, a variable refresh rate up to 120Hz, up to 500 nits of brightness, and 120% DCI-P3 color volume. On top of all that, with this special anti-reflective glass coating, this is the best display I've seen on a laptop so far, ever. Windows 11 looks extra smooth thanks to the high refresh rate, text is always sharp even when you zoom out for a large spreadsheet, and the colors look so nice and vibrant for video playback. Especially for HDR video, you can see the peak of what this display can do, and it really is fun to look at anything on this display. I don't even think it's overdoing it either. Colors are accurate, and I'm comfortable using this for photo editing without worrying. And with the 16:10 aspect ratio, it's perfect for browsing and for viewing and editing documents. Being anti-reflective and how bright it can get, I can comfortably use this laptop in outdoor settings like a balcony or outdoor seating at a cafe and have no issues getting work done. Since the display is so good, I am a little disappointed in the speakers. It is a quad speaker setup with Dolby Atmos, but they're bottom mounted. There is a wedge design to make space for the sound to actually come up from the bottom. It sounds decent, there's bass and gets more than loud enough for indoor environments, but it sounds a bit flat without much range or sharpness, and there is distortion at higher volumes. With how amazing the display is, this laptop deserves better speakers, but it just missed the mark on that. Then there's the 1080p 2-megapixel front-facing camera with dual-ray mics.
So this is how it looks and sounds. I think it's okay. Not too bad or good, just good enough for video calls.
What's cool here is thanks to the MPU inside, you can use all these camera studio effects like background blur, eye contact, auto framing, voice focus, and more.
This is a test without any effects on, and this is a test with all the effects on, including automatic framing, portrait light, eye contact, background effects.
Just like StudioFX, there's a ton of software and AI features and ecosystem advantages you can consider if you have the Galaxy Book 4 Edge. Copilot is integrated in almost every Microsoft app, and you can quickly activate it with the Copilot button. There's Live Caption, which uses the NPU to live translate and caption any conversation or speech from media being played on the laptop. There's also Paint Image Creator, which basically totally reimagines your drawings and sketches using AI. To be honest, a lot of these AI features, especially Image Creator, are all fluff to me, and the NPU seems to go to waste most of the time. I mean, I do use Copilot a lot, but the integration right now is just a web app, and you can use Copilot or ChatGPT on a Mac, so this isn't a special feature for this laptop. What I do care about is all the things you can do between this laptop and my Samsung Galaxy phone, which actually are really convenient. If you're curious about those details, definitely check out my most recent video about the Samsung ecosystem. Okay, with all that AI stuff out of the way, what's the deal with Windows on ARM and how's the actual performance? I've already covered the Windows ARM app compatibility topic in the last few videos, so definitely watch those for the nitty-gritty, but to summarize, it's good, not great, but it's finally good now. And just for extra context, here are the internal specs for the Galaxy Book 4 Edge. I love the new baseline 16 gigs of RAM and higher storage that all these new Copilot Plus PCs have. Sadly, even after you open it up, you can't upgrade anything inside, but for base specs, I think it's good enough for most people looking at this laptop. The 8100 is not the highest end version of the Snapdragon X Elite chipset, but it's going to be the version most users will experience, and at least in benchmarks, it matches or even beats the Apple M3 chipset in some areas. For most general day-to-day apps like 10 plus tabs or browsing, having Spotify on, working in office apps and using a monitor and connecting accessories, I found the performance to be near perfect. I really didn't feel like I was compromising at all using a non-Intel or non-AMD device for everyday computer things. The new translation layer Prism successfully emulates most general day-to-day x86 or x64 software, and the performance drop for apps that aren't ARM native is actually very, very minor at just around 10 to 50%. Besides the app launch time being a little slower sometimes, in actual use, I found no performance differences, and I was very satisfied using any x86 or x64 app that could run. Now, I say it like that because there are some apps that just won't run, either because the developer has blocked it themselves or sometimes it just won't open. For most people with general daily computing needs, you won't have any compatibility or performance issues here. The only issue I found for general users is actually not ARM related, and that's connectivity. I found this laptop to lose internet connection really often. It will still be connected to a Wi-Fi network, but it just won't load anything and run into errors. It would work again after turning Wi-Fi off and on, and I'm sure this is a solvable issue with driver updates, but definitely wanted to point that out. On the other hand, for specific professional or security software, creative apps, or games with anti-cheat, you will most likely run into incompatibility or stability issues. For me, basically everything works perfectly, including photo editing software, game launchers, and all my productivity apps like Asana and Notion, except for one critical piece of software, and that's DaVinci Resolve. It's my main video editor and is available here as a public beta, but it's been so unstable, crashing, becoming unresponsive, and the performance has been so slow that I just can't edit on here. I'm open to using Adobe Premiere Pro, but Adobe still hasn't made a publicly available beta at the time of making this video. But considering how smooth 4K rendering has been on simpler video editors like Clipchamp, this is definitely more of a software issue and not anything to do with internals lacking power. There's even more evidence of this with a surprisingly decent gaming performance. None of the games I'm showing here are ARM native and are all being emulated through the translation layer. Of course, not all games run, but about 70% of my Steam library runs on here without much hiccups. With medium to sometimes high settings, I was achieving about 40 frames per second for most games, and some lesser demanding games ran at 60 frames or higher. During day-to-day tasks, even photo editing and most of my usage, this laptop barely gets warm and the fans are silent. But with high performance modes on for something heavier like gaming or video editing, the fans on this laptop turn up to turbo and they get very loud and hot too. From its base 30 degrees Celsius, I saw this laptop get all the way up to 50 degrees for some games. I found the performance to be relatively stable for gaming, so it doesn't really affect your gameplay, but something to keep in mind. But yeah, if you're more of a casual gamer that does a lot of productivity work and you want a thin, sleek laptop like this, this Galaxy Book 4 Edge can definitely work for you on the performance side. On top of that, the performance on this laptop will only improve as more devs get on board to fix these incompatibility issues and we get more driver updates from Samsung and Qualcomm. Performance is good, but how is it battery life and are the efficiency claims legit? So the Galaxy Book 4 Edge comes with a 56 watt hour battery and can charge up to 65 watts via USB-C. Samsung claims that this 14 inch Galaxy Book 4 Edge can get up to 20 hours of video runtime. There's no doubt about those claims when we're strictly talking video playback, but in my real-world day-to-day usage with mostly messaging apps, email, browsing, and video playback, I got about 6 to 9 hours of actual screen on time. I use a mix of x86 and ARM native apps for my daily usage, and I'm sure most of you will too, so this is a fairly realistic result that you'll get. That doesn't sound mind-blowing because there are some Intel or AMD-based ultrabooks that can achieve that as well, but compared to the vast majority of Windows laptops, even at this price tag, this is still one of the best battery performance out there and you will be very satisfied. A big part of that is extremely good standby time. After 15 hours of not touching this laptop, the battery only went down about 3%. Sadly, like all Windows laptops, it still does go into hibernation mode sometimes for slower wake-up times, but the default time to hibernation mode is noticeably longer than Intel or AMD-based laptops, so that part is better. The 65-watt charging is decent, getting you from 0 to 45% in just about 30 minutes, but it does take a full 2 hours to get from 20 to 100, so it's definitely not the fastest charging laptop out there. So putting everything together, the Samsung Galaxy Book 4 Edge is a good laptop with justified specs for the price. There's some noticeable big wins, including the display and the keyboard. The general daily performance is excellent for the most part, and the battery life is great. But at this price, I am a bit bummed by some of the hardware decisions. The battery life is great, but it didn't impress me as much as I thought it would. And while basically all my non-professional apps all work fine with Windows on ARM, there's definitely going to be some instability and incompatibilities that other users are going to run into that regular users shouldn't have to worry about. I'm confident software compatibility will get better throughout the next few months, but for right now, I can't recommend the Galaxy Book 4 Edge as an obvious choice for most people looking for a new laptop. If you are tech savvy and interested in a Snapdragon X Elite laptop, I think this is a good laptop. But from what I've seen so far, I would first look at the Surface Laptop 7 for higher quality hardware, or the Lenovo Yoga Slim 7X for a better overall deal. Okay, so that's going to do it for this video. Let me know in the comments your thoughts on the Galaxy Book 4 Edge and the Copilot Plus PCs as a whole. I'd love to know if you had the same or a different experience from me. Make sure to subscribe to the channel for more videos like this. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys on the next video.